What is up, you guys? Welcome back to another video, and I hope it was having a great day. And welcome to my channel. If you are new, my name is Jai, and we are reacting to another video of Mr. Nook's top 5 videos that will creep, that will freak you out. So sit back, relax, and let's get into it.
Five ghosts caught on camera.
I hope
St.
we didn't
Charles
see these,
Hotel. On
but
the
I, but
YouTube Ghost
I don't
Hunting
think
Channel,
I
the
did.
haunted side, lead investigator Patrick and his cameraman Jason are investigating the supposedly very haunted St. Charles Hotel in Carson City, Nevada. The hotel has been in continuous operation for over 150 years. So obviously it's had its fair share of tragic events occurring inside its walls. Almost immediately, the Haunted Side guys begin to experience unexplained activity.
And we're going back in.
Did I? I don't think I did.
I don't even see anything in here that's metal.
No, there's no debris.
Nothing changed.
Patrick and Jason head to the hotel's most haunted rooms to continue their investigation.
So we're standing out front of room 305 and 304. Which should we go first, 304?
304.
And again, this is the floor where there's a lady from the 1800s that is seen around here a lot. So let's go see if we can talk to her.
And now, this is when things get truly bizarre.
Do you have something you want to say? Come and talk to us. Yeah. That was weird.
It's pretty sad that these ghosts are trapped.
Is that you? I felt like a little touch or like a little pressure.
Now, at first this clip might not seem that compelling, but right after Patrick is touched, watch what their night vision camera catches.
That was weird. Is that you?
Did you see it? Now, this chilling capture of a pale apparition might be a bit hard to see on a darker phone screen or a monitor. So, I've enhanced the video just a bit. But note, nothing was added to the Haunted Side's original video. It has only been adjusted to highlight what was already there.
Is that you?
Next, Patrick and Jason move to room 305, a room which is also said to be a hotbed of paranormal activity. They capture some very odd temperature fluctuations in the room. But the most chilling footage of all happens just after they walk out.
Both Jason and myself had to leave this room. Little did we know we were about to capture something unbelievable.
Well, I don't see it.
Did you see it? Again, I'll enhance the video. Take another look.
Oh.
Some creepy figure seems to just be standing idly in the corner with its head down. When they leave the room, it seems to raise its head and disappear into the bathroom. So did the Haunted Side catch a ghostly apparition in two separate rooms at the St. Charles Hotel? Let me know what you think down in the comments.
I mean, it seemed
below.
Like the ghost was waiting for them to leave. Like,
you
it's, like, it's
the
not
Haunted
like the
Side's
ghost.
Complete uncut investigation
they can see you.
Over on their YouTube channel. Catalina, Catalina. So everyone has heard of the Bloody Mary party game and the Charlie Charlie Challenge. But this next video features an odd supernatural game that I've never heard of before. Two girls
Me
are
neither.
Gathered in front of a creepy doll. Each time they recite a line, they light a candle at the doll's feet. And it didn't go well.
Uh-oh.
Es una niña que llora y se queda miedo.
Nada, son
Pura hija, mira, ya estoy grabando. Mi abuelita dice, alto, miedo, le tienes, apaga la luz. Ya, ya. Tu mamá ha hecho ritual con tus amigos, dice que alto, miedo, da.
No creo. ¿Verdad? Vas a ver.
All right, you gonna get what you're looking for, lady.
Catalina, Catalina, vuelve a la vida. Lo que el diablo te da, el diablo te quita. Catalina, Catalina, vuelve a la vida. Lo que el diablo te da, el diablo te quita. En nombre del demonio, manifiéstate hoy, aquí y en este día. En nombre del demonio, manifiéstate hoy, aquí y en este día.
This video was sent in by a viewer who says she found it on a random Spanish language website. I searched for the source or even mention of this Catalina ritual that the girls are doing, but nothing showed up. So I leave it to you to decide. Is this a haunted doll caught on camera, or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide.
Well, it has to be something because they mentioning the devil and all whatnot. And talk about manifest right now.
Channel MindSeek TV. Casey Nolan and fellow investigator Tanner McBride hear about a small abandoned town called Rodney, Mississippi. The ghost town is located deep in the countryside, and its decaying buildings are said to be intensely haunted. Well, it turns out that the reason the town was abandoned is because Rodney, Mississippi experiences frequent flooding.
We know Rodney's flooded different times of the year. We knew it was very possible that it could be flooded during our trip, but we had no idea that we would be stopped by water almost a mile away from the actual town of Rodney.
So this is really the direction that we gotta go right now?
It says it's like a mile and a half that way.
Even worse, when the floodwaters are high, alligators are known to hunt in the murky streams. As if that wasn't bad enough, there are also deadly snakes hiding under the water's surface.
Watch for snakes.
The locals have been telling us that there are water moccasins and they are active.
Every fucking stick feels like an alligator to me, dude.
It got a little bit deep at times. It was like wastes.
Watch.
Oh, it's getting deeper. I'm almost up to my waist right now. I'm almost up to my waist.
That definitely looked like an eye. Behind those bushes. Yeah. And now it's gone. Like I got a reflection when I was looking over that way. And then it disappeared. Which freaks me the f*** out because it makes me believe now that something went underwater. Doesn't mean it's like a big one or anything, but it definitely could be an alligator.
After tromping a mile and a half through the muddy floodwaters, the MindSeek TV guys finally reach the town. They investigate the allegedly very haunted Old Town Church.
And that's the building they're talking about. Alright, well, we're gonna do this. Alright, let's go.
While investigating the old church, they decide to start reading prayers to try to provoke a reaction from any spirits that might haunt the building. And it seems to work.
You don't blaspheme just to get a reaction?
The larger one to govern the day and the smaller one to govern the night. Hey, did you hear something? Like downstairs? The larger one to govern the day and the smaller one to govern the night.
We're hearing like a bunch of scratching and a couple of thud noises.
I've been hearing stuff the whole time.
You heard, like, thump, right?
Yeah, the whole time I've heard two. At least three.
There's a lot of f***ing noise going on. It sounds like scratching, though, right? Like scratching noises on the wall? Don't move for a second.
What's your hair, Papa?
It sounded big. wasn't like a squirrel or a rat.
Yeah, but I don't know what the f*** it could be.
I have no idea.
And it just gets weirder. Later, as they are just about to leave the church, this.
What the f*** was that? That was big. That sounded like something jumped right there, eh?
One, two, they're coming after you. Three, four, you better run out the door. Five, six, drive a cruiser. Six, seven, eight, don't be insane. Nine, ten, better get where they stay.
Did you feel that?
I was, ooh. I had like in my chest, like dead in the center of my chest, dude.
It sounds like the heavy footsteps of someone or something charging down the stairs at them. But
it has to be the man of the house. I don't know. I don't know the whole story, or maybe I was listening to
it. It sounded like someone came charging down the stairs at us. The footsteps sounded loud, aggressive, and once it reached the bottom of the steps, I felt a breeze blow past me, and Tanner said he felt heat inside of his chest.
They check out the rest of the abandoned ghost town. And then decide to call it a night, trekking back through the creepy swamp. So did the Mindsee TV guys catch real paranormal proof on camera? You decide. You can check out the Mindsee TV YouTube channel for this full, unfiltered investigation. Supernatural Interference. This next creepy video comes from Monterrey, Mexico. According to the story, a woman was hit by a car on this street and lost her life. It is said that the woman passed away just as the ambulance arrived to pick her up. The roadside stone and cross now mark the spot of the tragic event. But here's where things get very strange. Local residents soon began to realize that every time they passed by this grim roadside marker while listening to radio station 690 AM, their car stereo reception was interrupted. Interrupted by the absolutely unexplainable sound of an ambulance siren.
That's like you had some crystal in your car.
Bueno, aquí estamos, buenas noches. Ya es mi última noche en Monterrey, ya mañana. Buenos días, perdón. Son las. Casi las. Casi las 3 de la mañana.
Buenas noches, raza. Estamos en una calle. Donde se supone una persona falleció. Se supone, se dice que cuando llegas para allá, donde está la cruz, más o menos por donde va la camioneta aquella, se distorsiona este pedo y empieza a sonar una ambulancia. No se sabe si es verdad, pero bueno, se dice. Vamos a pasar por ahí, pues, a ver qué pedo.
Ahí tenemos ya la estación.
La misma.
690.
La misma.
Y aquí vamos.
Had posted this experience, I would be inclined to just dismiss it as a hoax. But multiple drivers have had this same chilling experience while driving down this road. And the creepy interference only occurs near this one particular spot.
Thank you.
That's crazy.
And there are many more clips like these online. So just what is causing this bizarre interference?
I don't know if it was somebody in a car, because I heard a lady screaming. I'm not sure if that was the part of the, when you passed by through the cross, I don't know.
Scariest things. Some people believe that very young children can see things, particularly supernatural things, that adults just aren't aware of. Judging by the clips I'm about to show you, let's just hope that that's not true. In this classic YouTube video that was originally filmed in 1990, YouTube user DogZapper50 is filming his 2-year-old daughter Blair as she sits with the family. Things suddenly take a very strange turn.
Yeah, push your elbow. Look here, that's your elbow.
Seems to be taking the situation very seriously. She seems to really believe that she just saw a ghost. And it's even odder that she somehow comes up with this line.
Yeah.
TikTok user Ashley Rayfield is sitting in the car outside her house.
You want to feel some tea on that?
Just suddenly tells her something that, well, is just totally chilling.
In the tree.
Honey, there's nobody in the tree.
Up there.
You can see somebody?
Yeah.
Are you sure? I don't see anybody, honey.
I see a girl.
You see a girl?
Yeah.
Oh, is she okay?
Yeah.
What's she doing?
On her tummy. It's dead. Dead.
Honey, how did... I don't think there's a dead girl in the tree, baby. There's nothing in the tree.
It's dead. Look, see? I see it. It's dead.
What? The tree is dead?
No. A girl's dead.
Why do you think there's a girl dead?
Up here.
Up there? But why? I don't get it.
You heard that?
So we're sitting here in front of this tree, and all of a sudden Elijah tells me that there's a girl that died. And I said, no, honey, there's no girl dead. And he goes, yeah.
Actually,
she's stuck in the tree. There's nothing in this tree.
YouTuber Biffy usually only posts gaming videos. But when he caught this chilling footage of his daughter seemingly interacting with something, he had to post it. This footage was captured at 3:45 a.m. when Biffy says his daughter just randomly woke up and seemed to be interacting with someone or something in the room.
Now, it may just be random baby chatter, but she actually seems to shout, "Die, die, die," at something. And then she recoils as if she's a bit scared. She covers her eyes and even pulls the blanket up over her head. So just what did Biffy's daughter see? Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. You can suggest videos you like or submit videos of your own at Nukes.
Okay, now, Monty does similar things, but it's mainly in the morning, and she doesn't mention die. She's just bored most of the time. When it's the morning time, or when it's time to go to bed. But yeah, kids don't lie. When they see it, just like innocent little dogs. When they see something, they're gonna say it. Kids would not lie. I mean, when I say kids, smaller kids. And yeah. And I don't know why, if people are scared to go somewhere, and you're panicking, why you're still there, why you go in the first place. Yeah, that was it for Mr. Nukes. Creepy, that will freak you out. 5 Skate Videos. So thank you guys for tuning in. Tell me guys what you think. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all the great stuff. And get a big thumbs up. And until next time, guys, it's your life. Do what you want and do it positively. Peace.